What we will do today, the Attorney General, Secretary Shalala, and I, is try and lay out for you the product of the better part of 2 months of very intense work, which represents the thinking of the entire government. First of all, we're going to send a clear message to all federal employees, to all federal contractors, to all organizations receiving federal funds, and to all employees who work with the safety of the American public, that Schedule I drugs are against the law and won't be tolerated. And you'll see that in the outline of the administration proposal. The second major principle we espouse is one of education. We think it is perhaps one of the few good things that may come out of all of this is to reassert the requirement to explain to young people, to this new generation, and indeed to our the parents who are caring for them, the dangers of drug abuse in America. And so it's fundamentally going to be based on us consulting with medical organizations and with coalitions across America to underscore the dangers implicit in Schedule I drugs. The third point I would underscore is the federal government's responsibility as a public trust to ensure that safe and effective medicines are provided to the American people. It's a very special responsibility. It's been done with brilliance by the National Institute of Health, the Food and Drug Administration, the DEA. It's prevented thalidomide and laetril and other nonsense substances from going in front of the American people. American medicine is clearly, without question, the best in the face of the earth, and we owe them a responsible scientific medical process. And then finally, and I'll let the Attorney General deal with this, we would underscore that federal law enforcement provisions remain in effect. Nothing has changed. Federal law is unaffected by these propositions. There's a bit of humor in this slide. Here's what we're worried about. This is not a medical proposition. This is the legalization of drugs that we're concerned about. Here's what the medical advisor in the state of California saw as a potential uses of marijuana. And, you know, it includes recalling forgotten memories, cough suppressant, Parkinson's disease, writer's cramp. It simply does not include a doctor's diagnosis, a medical prescription. This is not medicine. This is a Cheech and Chong show. Now, what we are committed to doing is to looking in a scientific way at any proposition that would bring a new medicine to the assistance of the American medical establishment. Please.
General McCaffery, did you think the voters in California and Arizona made a mistake? Were they fooled? Do you just disagree?
We, I think all of us have enormous faith in the American people. If they have the facts, they make good judgments. And in this case, I think part of the problem was we call these hoax initiatives, stealth initiatives, that you simply couldn't, as an intelligent person, read the ballot initiative in Arizona in particular, but neither state, and get the notion that you weren't talking about compassionate care of the terminally ill. You were talking writer's cramp and the quasi-legalization of drugs.
And quickly to recap some of the issues, Barry McCaffery, his opinion was quite direct and quite obvious. He said about 20 minutes ago, quote, "This is not medicine. This is a Cheech and Chong show," end quote. There's the administration's position.
They specifically ridiculed Dr. Micaria's list of Prop 215 conditions. And they mocked the very thing that Todd was observing, the range of conditions. They thought that was proof that it was a hoax, which was a word McCaffery used. And the fact that marijuana treats such a wide range of conditions, Todd said, this says something about its mechanism of action. It's affecting various systems of the body. It's easing the pace of the body's response. He intuited what was happening on the biochemical level. And it turns out this thing that they mocked him for, the wide range of conditions, might actually be Todd's single most important observation, clinical finding. And of course, we now know that it jibes perfectly with what the biochemists and pharmacologists have found, which is that it's working to slow down the tempo of neurotransmission from the other neurotransmitter systems.